Hello friends, I am Engajan from Skill on Tech. Today I am coming with a video particular for H2S piping. Why weld joints fail in H2S sour gas exposed pipes? Leak inspection and remedies. The video become very interesting, hence please see the complete video. And if you like this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues. Why weld joints, heat affected zone in pipe and fittings fail in H2S gas or H2S saturated liquid processing? You can see a picture where a welding of a pipeline is carrying out. As we know, H2S is a poisonous gas and may be present in the pipeline. So, while doing any welding jobs, the pipeline shall be completely drained, flushed and purged with nitrogen, and ensured that there is no H2S gas present in the pipeline. H2S is highly toxic gas and release in atmosphere may cause casualty and fatality in excessive release dose. Materials in sour environment are susceptible to sulfide stress corrosion cracking, SSC, the well-known cracking in the H2S service pipelines. Hydrogen induced cracking, hydrogen embrittlement, exfoliation, HEHIC. It leads to various mode of failures including stepwise cracking. Hence the important during the design stage on material selection is very important. 4.3 to 46% in atmosphere leak of H2S may be highly inflammable. TLV of H2S is 10 ppm. Failure regions of weld joint. You can see a picture where H2S corrosion is shown. In oil and gas pipelines and other plants, exposure to soap, H2S containing environments can induce premature service failure. Corrosion reactions involving H2S produce hydrogen, which enters the base metal. It ingrains in the material and may embrittle it, leading to sulfide stress corrosion cracking. The SSC susceptibility of steels increase with hardness and strength. Avoidance of the problem therefore require limitation to be imposed on material hardness. So material hardness is very one important factor in H2S service. So the hardness of material should not be increased more than RC22 in any case. This is particularly important at welded joints where rapid cooling produces hardened microstructures in the heat affected zone. Material selection as per NACE standards. Any material which is selected for H2S service shall be as per NACE standards. Structure of NACE MR0175. So part 1 is a NACE MR0175 ISO 15156-1 general principles for selection of cracking resistant materials, and part 2 defined MR0175 ISO 15156-2 petroleum and natural gas industries material for use in H2S containing environments in oil and gas production. Part 2 is a cracking resistant carbon and low alloy steels. And part 3 is a cracking resistant CRAs, corrosion resistant alloys and other alloys. IGC testing for SS material. You can see a picture where intergranular corrosion attack in austenitic cold rolled stainless steel is shown. So you can see here at the grain boundaries, this intergranular corrosion attack is shown. Intergranular corrosion is a selective attack in the vicinity of the grain boundaries of stainless steel. It is as a result of chromium depletion, mainly due to the precipitation of chromium carbide in the grain boundaries. At elevated temperatures, this chromium is depleted and precipitated at grain boundaries of the material. So the internal structure of the material is without chromium. It leads to corrosion. Chromium carbide can be precipitated if the stainless steel is sensitized in the temperature range 550 to 850 degrees centigrade. For example, during heat treatment of welding, if the temperature lies in the critical range for too long, chromium carbides will start to form in the grain boundaries, which then become susceptible to intergrain wall corrosion cracking. SS316L is the best material for H2S service application. Hence, all the SS materials shall be tested for IGC before use. Failure investigation. You can see a picture where a failure of a weld joint is shown due to corrosion. Failure investigation revealed the following causes: deposit corrosion, erosion and corrosion, hardness increase due to cold work, and hydrogen embrittlement. Therefore, this hydrogen increase in the material also leads to failure of the material. Therefore, fine grain material is used to avoid ingress of hydrogen ions in the material. Material selection for H2S gas, H2S saturated liquid pipe and fittings. Metallurgical properties, composition, method of manufacture, product form, strength, hardness, amount of cold work, heat treatment conditions, and microstructure shall be ensured. Laboratory testings. Lab testing in accordance with the all parts of NACE specification may be used, such as physical properties, impact test, solution annealing for SS pipe and fittings, low carbon such as 316L, defect free without any flaws, SSC test, IGC test, etc. Hardness of material restricted to HRC 22. It should be always less than HRC 22. Defect free, flawless, and pipe thickness as per design code ASME Division 2. Hydro test of all pipeline as per ASME code 31.3. Material must meet ASTM requirements. Field experience. A material could be qualified by documenting field experience, and then material shall be used for H2S service. Because as we use the material in our service, this also gives us exposure how our pipelines are responding and giving a life against H2S service. Hydrogen sulfide gas released from piping corrosion failure near a weld. You can see a picture of process flow diagram where a scrubber is shown and a process diagram is shown. Hydrogen sulfide corrosion has been reason for of catastrophic failures have and will continue to occur. The failures have been observed in industries and oil rigs at offshore. A hydrogen sulfide gas release occurred in industries due to failure of weld joints, heat affected zone area of pipe and fittings. In this picture you can see where a reducer is used. The weld joint of reducer become fail and H2S release has occurred, and that causes a shutdown of the complete plant, which make a huge production losses. Therefore, for H2S service, the piping selection must be very specific and as per standards. Corrosion. You can see a picture where corrosion due to H2S is shown. You can see fittings on the material. The flow line failed due to internal corrosion, which reduced the wall thickness until it could not longer contain the normal operating pressures. Corrosion was caused by condensed liquid water reacting with H2S gas to form corrosive acid gas. Due to deposit of process flows near the drain pipeline areas also lead to a heavy corrosion in the pipeline tanks, bottoms of the towers, and which lead to corrosion due to failure occurs in the weld joints. Therefore, this deposit corrosion is also one very important specific reason for failure due to corrosion in H2S service. CS material for H2S sour gas service. Low temperature service material shall be used with impact tested A333 grade 6 pipes and A420 WPL6 elbows, A352 LF2 flanges shall be used, A516 grade 70 plate material shall be used. All the material shall be defect free, UT tested and as per ASTM standards, and testing shall be done with due procedure. All the components shall be designed as per ASME standards. Welding of CS pipe shall be done as per suitable electrode of low hydrogen content. AWS E7018-1 grade super thumb special electrode. All the root joints shall be done with TIG welding with argon purging with suitable filler. All the weld joints shall be stress relieved up to 650 degree centigrade of CS pipelines. Inspection of pipes. Inspect all piping with similar internal exposures, that is wet, sour gas, where water and deposits can accumulate, and replace if extensive corrosion is identified. Review inspection and maintenance programs for piping exposed to sour gas and include procedures for identifying localized corrosion problems using radiography or other non-destructive inspection methods where normal ultrasonic inspection may not be effective, such as the areas near welds, reducers and flanges. Verify that your safety and environmental management system program adequately address the design, inspection, testing and quality assurance of piping exposed to sour gas in order to prevent the buildup of elemental sulfur and to identify and remediate areas of excessive corrosion so that similar releases of H2S gas can be prevented. Welding procedure and inspection of weld joints. Make WPS. Record PQR, perform WPQ. Means first we have to make welding procedure specification, then we shall record PQR, perform welder performance test, root DP of all weld joints, 100% radiography of all weld joints greater than 2 inch NB of butt welds. Schedule of pipe shall be as per pressure and temperature with adequate design as per code. Below 2 inch NB, socket weld joints are preferred. 100% stress relieving of all weld joints of CS pipelines. SS316L shall be used for process pipelines containing H2S. Pipe shall be IGC tested and solution annealed. Hydro test of pipeline as per ASME section at division 1 or ASME 31.1 or 31.34 power and process piping accordingly. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below, share it with your friends and colleagues, subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.